Hello everyone, welcome to another live stream here at YouTube. Thank you for joining me. I know this is a weird time. Like normally it's either at night or it's on Fridays in the middle of the day. This is Thursday in the middle of the day. It's weird, I know. But that's because I have a special phone a friend edition of this live stream. I'm gonna be trying out, I talked about it a few weeks ago that I bought the Spellbinders Glimmer hot coil system over a year ago and I've never broken it out. Well, today I broke it out and we're gonna try it out. So I'm calling in a friend and you guys know her. It's Jennifer McGuire. She looks shocked. She's like, hey. Hi, Jennifer.
How much are you paying me to do this again?
Zero.
Oh, shoot. Oh, dear. I'm so welcome. Nervous.
Welcome to YouTube Live. You haven't done a live on YouTube, have you? You've just done some Facebook stuff, right?
No, I did a live with Jeff a while ago, and that's I haven't right, recovered right. yet.
This will just
But the best
right
part
back.
About this is you do the work. I'm just
it's
hanging
true.
Out.
You're just, you are going to be my muse is not mentor. Mentor. You are my mentor.
I'm going to be that little crafter on your shoulder is what I'm going to be.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Here we go. So, all right. I'm going to switch over to my little overhead thing. Jennifer's going to be in the corner.
Look at
all
that.
All right. So, I know. Here we are. Here's my little glimmer machine. I have not done anything with it other than plug it in and make sure it powered on. It had a few little things with it. I'm going to have to ask you what they're for because okay. Some of it, because I've seen in videos, like I kind of have an idea, but okay. So it came with, well,
hey, I'm not an expert, by the way. I'm not an expert. I'll try my best.
But you've used it a lot. You
yes.
have like experience.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, I love
okay,
this thing.
So the other stuff that it came with, I mean, these two plates, which I, from what I gather in the instruction manual, when you use each one depends on your material. Is that right?
I use them all the time. Because if you're doing it on paper, you'll need both of them.
Okay. All right. So keep and on. Then there's this. What is this?
So the plates will be hot when you take them off. So okay. for safety reasons, that is a place that you can put it to cool. And also there are little like big giant tweezers to pick up the hot
these,
plates.
Right?
Yeah. I think there's a magnet on one that allows you to
oh,
pick
yeah.
it up via magnet. Yep.
Yeah, there's
but,
a magnet for
you know,
sure.
I just see like my fingers are in bad shape, so I just kind of.
I'm gonna be it. Like precision surgery, like
I know.
Deep, deep, deep,
I know you will.
So dainty.
I know.
Okay. All right. So, can you use this glimmer machine in die cutting machines other than any Spellbinders machines? Do you know?
I have heard you can use it in the Big Shot, but I don't know that for sure. It is designed to go with the Spellbinders machine. However, there are machines, other machines that are very similar that work with other die cut machines. And they're just as okay. good. So there's a machine okay. that works with the Gemini. But if you have a Spellbinders machine, this is what you use. And it works very easily.
Okay, this doesn't get hot underneath. So I'm okay to have it on my mat, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I would maybe just want to move yeah, this off to the side or something, right?
Sure. The part that gets hot is the gray area there in the center.
Yeah, there's some heat.
Yep.
Like I'm like,
yep.
mm-hmm. Warm your hands over a glowing fire. Okay. So I have, I guess the easiest thing to do would just be do some foiling, right? See how it goes.
Yep.
I have a bunch of different things here. I've got three from Simon that just came out, but then mm-hmm. I also have some specifically from Spellbinders, and I really want to do something from this one, which is okay. the mini Christmas sentiment strips, because I thought we could do
okay.
a bunch of them all on white
yeah.
and then do something. Okay, so what am I doing?
I would start with that one there. That's a good one. And we can talk okay. about those giant ones, like that giant one from Simon. You got to get
yeah,
a little creative
one.
With it because it doesn't fit on there.
But oh,
I can
right,
we can do that later, but let's start simple.
Okay. All right, so we're going to do some little sentiments.
Yes, and look at all those.
I know, and it comes with a die, it looks like, that you can
yep.
cut them out too. So I'm going to yep. try to space them out. So can I just like cover all of this with these?
You know what I recommend doing is lay down onto your desk the sentiments you want face down, kind of lined up with a little space between. They don't have to be perfectly spaced because you can use that die to cut them out. But you want a little bit of space so you can have that room for that die to cut them apart after. Okay. So just put some down, and then when you're happy with how many you have, put a couple pieces of tape to connect them all so you can work with them as one.
Oh, okay. That's a good idea because then you don't have to worry about spacing it later.
Yeah, I just...
Or spacing it on this hot, like, surface.
It, you can do that, but this way it's easier to figure out what size foil you want to cut, what cardstock you want to cut. I just find this easier. And that way you can do multiples of these if you wanted to, too, because they'll still be connected.
Okay. So question. I think I'm going to just try to do all of these at the same time.
Okay. Sure.
Okay. So I think I'm remembering correctly that foil is like resistant, like ink resistant. Is this true?
Yeah. So do you mean you can ink over it?
Yes.
Yes. Yep.
So if I wanted it to be like a black background with foil, I could just do all of these on white and ink it black.
Or you could just do it on black cardstock.
Yeah, but I'm thinking, you know, for ease of use, do all of these all at the same time. Yeah.
Right.
Okay, I'm using a big thing of post-it tape. Will that work?
I don't know. I've never tried it. I only use, like, masking tape. But we'll try it. I don't know if that tape is the, if that's too thick or not. We'll see. We'll find out.
Oh, because it's going to stay on it? It's going to stay on it.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. Do you have a piece of like purple tape or the Spellbinders yellow tape? Something like that.
I do. Yeah.
And then don't pick it up. Just leave it there. We have to get the foil and cardstock ready first before you move it over.
Okay. So we're not doing anything with that. Okay. All right. So I have some different colors of cardstock here. I thought I would do this with just on white. So let me
tell you a bit about the cardstock. But first, put a long piece of tape over that. Something thin.
Oh, to hold it.
Nervous. Yes, just to hold
it. Okay,
them all
well,
there.
You said don't do anything, so I wasn't going to
no,
do it.
No, I mean, I'm sorry. I
don't pick it up.
Don't pick them up and
don't
put them
up
on the machine yet.
Got it. Okay, where did my purple tape go? Here we go.
And there are
does it matter
ways
the thick purple
this.
Tape or the little purple tape? Does it matter?
It doesn't matter. I've used both, I think.
Okay, so like this little one will work.
Yeah, that should work. I usually use that easy C tape, but this should do it.
Oh, well. I have that too. Why didn't you say something?
I don't know. Because I'm hundreds of miles away. I don't know what you have.
That's okay.
And well, this is your maiden voyage. If one of them doesn't work, that's okay. We'll keep doing it.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Yay. So this is going to stay on here.
Just leave it there.
While it's being foiled. Oh, crap. Maybe I should do two of them.
No, it'll be fine. Just press over them. So now here's the thing with cardstock. Okay. You can foil on any cardstock. However, the smoother the cardstock, the better. In fact, Spellbinders has Glimmer Essentials cardstock, which I think is a synthetic cardstock.
I wish I would have ordered it.
I told you to order it.
I know, and I totally spaced it.
That's okay. But if you have super, super smooth cardstock, the smoother, the better. I know
so I have some
Yana,
Concord and Ninth is like super smooth. So
yes, Yana over at Spellbinders, who is brilliant, she did a video comparing different kinds, and the smoother the better.
Cool.
So I think this should work. I mean, I've used Nina, which isn't the smoothest of all cardstocks, and it works fine.
Cool. All right, so I've got some champagne foil here.
Mm, okay.
I like this color of gold. It's not too, like, yellowy.
Yeah. My favorite gold is the prism gold.
Okay,
it's like
I think
it got an iridescent to it. Yeah.
Is that the one?
I told you to get that. That silver over there is prism, yeah.
This
see how
silk?
Those have,
okay.
Yeah, they have like an iridescent
hold on,
look
is,
to it.
That's not prism, is it?
No, it, see the silver, how it's silver, but it has an iridescent shine to it? There's a gold
it's a little
like
bit holographic?
Yeah.
Okay. I think they were sold out.
It's okay.
I went to the Spellbinders website. Yeah, probably. Jennifer, stop it. You're buying everything. I went to the Spellbinders website, which by the way, for those of you who are wondering, they have a huge sale going on right now.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, it's so big that they're like, hey, our shipping's really slow. Sorry. So be patient, but you can get a good deal.
What's important is that you use a foil meant for machines. You don't want deco foil that you use like with a laminator. That's a different kind of foil. So all of these Glimmer hot foil rolls from Spellbinders will work great.
Okay. All right. I don't want to deal with this sticker, so I'm cutting it off. Okay. So I just want to make it big enough to cover the whole batch that we're doing, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So
now you'll have some leftover foil here, and you can be creative and save those little strips for later. Like if you only want to foil 1 centimeter at a time later on, I keep them all in a little tray. So I have those little scraps. So don't worry if you have some leftover.
I got to turn off my fan. It is like making my foil blow in the wind. So mental note, don't have a fan in your craft room while you're trying to foil.
Same with when you're using gilding flakes.
Oh my word. Yes. Or, well, I've had issues if you've got like a strong fan and you go to like pour on some embossing powder and it's like, whoo, you know, you might as well emboss your whole desk. Okay. So what do I do now?
Okay. So now you can set the foil over to the right, move it out of the way. Okay. Now peel off your tape and lay that onto your cardstock. So move all those foil plates onto your cardstock.
Like,
and don't press it down, just lay it there. Yep. And what you're going to do, I'll tell you what you're going to do. You're going to hold the top tape and hold everything up and slide your foil underneath.
Oh, okay. Is the foil face up? Wait.
Yes.
These are not touching the paper. Is that okay? It's the tape and then the plate on top.
Oh, no. Want the letters touch the paper.
Okay. Got it. All right.
Now just lift it up so you can slide that under it. This method I just recommend getting used to because if you have like an odd shape in a small piece of foil, it's easier to kind of slide it under the tape right up to the edge.
Sorry, you couldn't see it. That wasn't exactly what I did, but it was close.
That's fine. Now, here's the thing. Every time you want your plates to touch the pretty foil. In fact, let me check. Mike, can you go up there? I'm going to check. Because, you know, we don't want to mess up here. I mess up all the time. Can you open that up in the yellow container over on the right?
Let's look there.
One that says Glimmer. I'll show you
Place Glimmer foil. I want you to see this. Shiny side facing down. Oh, you're totally right.
I've messed it up so many times that let me show you what I did. Here's my machine. And I did, can you see this? I put a little label on it here. Where is it? Right there. See? It says... Pretty side of foil touches foil plate because I've messed it up so many times. So I
got it.
Okay. So pretty side touches the pretty letters. Now you're going to pick that all up and you're going
to. With the paper on it?
Yep. And you're going to flip it. And the hot foil plate lays on the hot area.
Flipping it like this.
Yep. Lay it on the.
Okay.
On the gray. Yep.
Okay.
Gosh, I'm so nervous. I wasn't this nervous delivering a baby.
Jeez. All right, I'm getting my platinum ready, right?
Because you don't need it yet. Oh, you're.
Do
you're
I need this timer?
Yes. Hold on.
Okay.
You see the green shim? Remember those two shims that came with it?
Uh huh.
Put the green shim down.
On top. Or just I want it handy.
No, you want it
like
on top.
Putting it.
Put it on top of the card stock. Gosh, this is making me nervous.
Okay.
Are we doing
on
this
there.
Right,
okay.
Mike? And then I usually I put a cardstock piece of cardstock in there between, but you can try it without.
Okay. Well, I still have that other side of my white cardstock. Where did it go?
If you want to, just lay it right there.
I don't know where it went.
Comments? Are people talking?
Oh, people are totally talking. Callie Person's here. Who else is here? Oh, yeah, there's lots of people here. Kim Kesty's here.
I can't.
Hey, Kim.
Can you make it so I see? Can you make it so I see the comments? Okay. I hope I haven't messed up yet. Just put that up there. Just put it on there.
Okay.
Now, see there's a button over there on the left?
Uh-huh.
Push it.
Is
it flashing?
I did. No.
Is your machine on?
Yeah,
I told you ahead of time to turn it on.
Yeah, there's heat. There was heat coming from it.
Okay. Did it say platform ready?
No.
Is it hot?
It was when I put stuff down. Yeah, there's heat coming off it.
Okay, try turning it off and turning it back on because the platform ready light is not on. It should be on. Huh.
It's broken. Okay, I'm making sure it's like pushed in really well.
Is the power light button on? or
yes.
light on?
Yeah. Can you okay. see that right there? It is on.
Yeah, there. Now I see that. But you need that platform light to be on. And it should be on to show that it's warming up.
It should be on when you turn it on?
No, it takes a few minutes. But you had it warming up.
Okay, I'm going to take it out and put it back in.
Yep.
Okay.
So what's happening, folks, is she had it plugged in, and usually after a few minutes that platform ready light comes on. And I know she had it plugged in. Maybe wasn't a strong connection in the platform.
Right.
Because you have to have the platform all the way pushed in.
So how many minutes does it usually take? Just a few?
Just a few. But we can talk until then.
Do we have to wait for it to say platform ready? Because it sounds like it probably should have already said it.
It'll tell you when it's ready. Okay, Kim Kesty, who works for Spellbinders, said, I have to turn mine off and on sometimes because it times out and turns off for safety.
Safety. Oh, got it.
That's what happened. So what happens is I had told her to warm it up beforehand so that it would be ready.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Platform ready.
So now see how that there's a green light that says platform ready. So you're good to go.
Uh-huh.
Now push that button.
Now push this button. Oh, there we go. Now timer's on.
It's going to flash.
It's blinking.
And so what it's doing is warming up your plates.
Okay.
So when it stops flashing is when we move over to the die cut machine. But just go ahead and give it some time. Hey, Kim Kesty, am I doing everything right? You better tell me if I'm not.
Okay.
Yep, see, that means it's heating. If it's flashing, it means it's warming up your plates. So what's happening is the machine is heating up your plates. The glimmer heats your plates, and your die cut machine will put pressure, and that causes the foiling to happen.
Got it.
And so this is unlike foil that you get other ways. It's beautiful.
This is totally okay to have this plate and everything on top while it warms up, right?
Yep, you're all good.
Okay. All right, I'm just going to slide this over. I'm getting ready.
I think that it sounds like the glimmer is like us.
Oh,
we just need to turn off every once in a while. Okay,
the timer is.
Do me a favor, before you take it out, turn your Spellbinders 90 degrees, or your Platinum 90 degrees. That'll help. Okay. Now what you're going to do, don't do it yet, pull the whole platform out with the plates on top, and then put it in your die cut machine. And run it through one way and then back the other way. And you don't have to be super fast. It's very forgiving.
Okay. In fact, the instructions that I did not read very much of it, but it did say put it through fairly slowly both directions.
Yeah, I usually, that's about what I do. And I like to go back too.
Okay. It does say go forward and back. So I think
it does?
Should.
See, I never read it. I just started doing it. See, I told you I'm not an expert.
Okay, so now do I go directly and put it right back in and plug it back in so it's ready for the next one?
That's what I do.
Okay.
So it's hot and ready for the next one. Yep. Okay. So now you can take off the plates. Kim is saying you didn't need that cardstock shim. For some reason with mine, it works better that way. I don't know. It looks. Did you do it? No, you didn't do one, so we'll see.
These are toasty.
Okay, so now.
Toasty.
Now, one of the reasons I usually tape everything together, so when I peel this off, the plates come with it, and I can just throw them off to the side. All right, good. So now you can kind of peel the foil and everything off and set it aside to cool. If you get foil where you don't think it should be, don't worry. We can take care of that. No panic.
Oh, I did.
We don't panic.
I did. You see that?
That's okay. That's okay. That's because it's a
big
piece.
Oh, I have lots where I don't want it.
No. It's okay. It's okay. I promise. Okay. So now what you can do, some of those, it looks like there was a, did you use a cardstock shim or not?
I did not.
Okay.
Let me zoom in so you can see this.
It looks like with yours, you do not need to have one because it looks like your machine puts a lot of foil. But do you see those little lines like around baby, it's cold outside? An eraser will take that off. Yep.
Really?
Eraser will take
like
that off.
Like a regular eraser or a sand eraser?
You could use either.
Okay.
And also, if you notice like maybe the center of your B's or your A's or O's, if you notice any of those are solid, just use a clean paintbrush and kind of brush those little extras a bit away.
Okay. Is there any reason why this one up here like didn't foil all the way? Sorry, it's hard to see.
I have no idea.
It might be that I just did too many all at once. I might have to do like, you know.
Yeah, it was a sale. And normally what I like to do is I trim a lot of the excess foil off, because you see those big blobs of foil on the side. That's because you had so much foil and paper and not much foil plate. Does that make sense? Uh-huh. That the pressure. So in this case, it doesn't matter that it's there. But if you were doing, say, like a Christmas bell, I would cut the foil a little bit closer, not right up against it, but a little bit closer so you don't have a chance of that. And somebody, I saw in the comments, somebody asked, can this be used with the Gemini machine? There is a different foil machine that works very much the same, with the same plates, that works with the Gemini machine. So if you have a Spellbinders, this is what you get. And it works great. And the Spellbinders is a great machine too.
Okay, all right, so you can erase. Up,
there you go.
Yeah, I cleaned up some of it, but I think this particular eraser that I have is maybe a little bit too soft.
Hold on. Okay, try the sand eraser. It just depends on how much you have there.
Well, I'm thinking just because this one's like a plastic eraser, maybe it just doesn't have enough.
That probably won't work as well.
I'm seeing if other ones will come off. Oh, yeah, this is taking things off a little bit better.
Someone said, where were you when I did this? Honey, can't you tell? I'm just winging it along with her. The funny thing is, I got to tell you guys, the funny thing about this is, Christina's like one of my, Christina and Gina are like my go-to people for advice in life. And Christina calls me and says, will you do a live where you teach me how to use a Glimmer machine? I'm like, finally, I can be useful.
Okay, the sand eraser is where it's at. Yeah. It takes it off without any effort at all.
And this guy, if you have this, the like electric eraser kind of thing, that's really what they brought it to market for, was to remove foil. So you could also use electric pencil eraser. Yep.
Okay, well, this is like my test. I think I'm going to probably do these again. So
let's do a bigger
because
one.
I'm curious.
How did it transfer? I can't really see. How did the foil transfer onto that cardstock well? It looks like it did.
It did transfer pretty well. I think I just need to, like, since it got so many of the edges and stuff.
Yes.
I kind of think maybe having the sentiments turned vertically, so as it rolls through, it won't, like, bump on the edge of the plates. I think that will help.
Okay.
I think that'll help.
Well, let's try one of your more solid ones.
Okay, yeah, let's try. I have a really pretty one from Spellbinders. I'm going to put it on this red because it is like a holiday one. Hold on, let me back out here so you can see what I'm dealing with.
Now, keep in mind, colored cardstocks are usually have a little bit of texture to it. I mean, not noticeable, but for something like this, it does make a difference. It is possible. But I'm going to tell you a little secret. I find two foils foil better than any others. And I think it's probably in my mind, it's probably a placebo thing because I think they're all the same. But that holographic or iridescent-y silver and the holographic and iridescent-y gold, I swear they foil better than all the others. So try that silvery one. Do you have that silvery one? Try that one.
Yes. So this is the Christmas foliage background. It's one of Yana's.
She is, man, that girl. She's got so much talent. Mm.
Okay.
Okay, so this one will be a good one to
put the tape on the plate. Does that matter?
It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all.
Well, that's okay.
Aaron said this is because holographic is the bomb. I agree, Aaron.
Okay, I don't think that's going to come off very easily, so we'll just leave it for now. Okay, so...
So you just want to do, what do you plan to do with this?
I'm going to have it down here on this edge. Okay. So you were
this
saying.
This is where tape comes in handy.
Yes.
Because if you want to get the position of the hot foil plate exactly in a certain spot, put a piece of tape right across the top edge there of that plate. Yeah, and by the way, for anybody who doesn't have a foil machine, you can use hot foil plates to make an impression on your cardstock too. It looks like a faux letterpress. It's really cool.
Okay, so I'm thinking,
put a piece
make
up there.
A little hinge.
So it's a little hinge. Yep. Now get your foil out, and you want to cut it kind of close to
this
that
one,
size.
Right?
Yes.
We want that one.
That's my favorite. Okay. Yes. Buy it in bulk, sister.
Well, if it's not sold out, thanks to you. I'm just saying, Jennifer. You're buying all the crafting stuff. Leave some for the rest of us.
Oh, you should have seen the mail I got today from the greetery. Oh,
good one.
I had to buy it all. Oh, it's so good. She's so good.
Okay.
Hey, Kim Kesty. Hey, Kim. Are those two silver and gold different than the others, or is it my imagination? You have to let me know in the comments. One of them's called Prism. I can't remember what the other one's called.
I think there was a Prism Gold when I looked.
Is it? Okay. Then I don't know what the silver one's called. Okay, now what I would do in this case is trim a little bit of that extra off on the bottom. And if you want to be really sure that this will be good, I would actually trim a little bit out of that little notch there in the bottom. Just a little bit.
Okay. Would it be worth it to go like this?
Sure.
I'm all, I can't eyeball like that.
Foil is tough to with scissors, but you want super sharp scissors for this.
Oh yeah, these are super sharp.
There you go. That's perfect. That's all you need to do. Because if you get a little extra foil from the edges of that, you can sand it away.
Okay, here we go. So we'll put that little hinge down and then pretty foil to the pretty side of the plate.
Yep, they got to kiss each other. There you go. And see how it slides up there and you keep, my brother's laughing. See, now notice, hold on, let me tell you something because I've learned this. See how you can see the foil sticking up? Close it. Go ahead and close it. See how
I'm just getting it lined up a little more. Yep. There
See how there's some foil up there on the top by their tape?
Right
That's
here?
That's good. Because you want to make sure it's high enough that it covers all of the plate. So you're good. If you want to, hold on. If you want to, put another piece of tape there on the bottom so it doesn't like move. There you go. When you flip it. Now you can pick it up and you'll be okay. Put it on the hot
Bring
portion.
It over here. It says platform's ready, so I can put it right down.
And then put your two shims on top.
Hold on, I'm getting this out of the way. I turned it around the wrong direction. Okay, my two shims.
Yep.
Okay.
I've always used those two shims. I guess they have two, so you can do it on different mediums, but I've never done it. So.
Well, I want to say in this instruction manual, it says cardstock. You do need both. So you're good.
Yep. And I've never done it on anything else.
I'm
a
real follower.
It works great on acetate. Oh, it looks so cool on acetate. Okay. Now, do you have both shims on there? I can't. It's
oh, yeah. I have to wait for the timer thing, huh? Okay. Hit timer.
So you push the button, and when it stops splashing, you're good. As far as tape, folks, it doesn't really matter what tape you use, just as long as it's kind of thin. Spellbinders has a yellow tape that looks like a thin masking tape, and it works good. And then that Easy C tape, which is this stuff, I have mine in my tape dispenser, but it's very thin, and that's what I usually use. But
sweet,
I just find it helpful because then you know where the foil will end up on your cardstock.
Totally.
And
all right. Well,
tape should probably work.
Maybe. I think I want to try this at least one more time, and then that one I'll switch to the Easy C tape that I have, and we'll see if it's any different. I don't think it's really going to be a huge difference one way or the other.
I don't think so. And somebody mentioned the acetate. If you foil on acetate, you do want to, you can try it with whatever acetate you have, but I do recommend a heat-resistant one. The Simon's Stamp heat-resistant acetate foils beautifully.
Awesome. I have that one.
Yes. It's out of stock now, and I'm waiting, and I'm going to buy like 9 million packs. Okay. Pick it all up. And then move it over to your die cut machine and go back and forth kind of slow, and you'll be good. And this is where you kind of say a little prayer, you know? Put some good thoughts into your
Dear crafting
foiling.
Gods.
Please deliver great foiling results.
Okay. All right, and we'll come over here.
Someone asked if the acetate has to be heat resistant. I haven't tried it not. With this much heat, I probably think it would, but you can try what you have. All right, here we go.
All right, so now we have to be careful, right?
You know what I do? I kind of like wave it a little bit. You know, you've got tough
Even
fingers.
With it like taped?
Yeah, you know. It is hot.
Okay, I'm just doing this so I can
Oh, you're such a
lift
wimp.
It up.
You're like the type who wears gloves when you get alcoholic. Mine okay. aren't.
All right, hold All on. Right. I got to put this hot plate on that little rubber mat thingy. Okay.
I don't even know where that rubber mat thing is.
Where do you put your hot plates?
You're fine. Just on my glass work surface or my counter?
All right. Are we ready for this? I could tell some of it foiled on the edges.
That's
so we'll
okay.
see.
That happens.
Ooh.
Look at that. We need
Not
to do
bad.
Like the sound effects next time. Now, do you have a clump of foil over on the side there? On the bottom left?
Like right here? Yeah, there's some mark on these edges.
Okay,
I'm not
try
sure
doing,
why.
The paintbrush might knock some of, a dry paintbrush might knock some of those connecting bits together.
Really?
Or like, see how it can kind of connected? I can't tell. But sometimes
okay,
open areas kind of connect. Does some of it come off?
Nope, not really, but that's a really soft brush. Hold on, let me see if I've got one that's a little more stiff.
Usually that's all you need, but you could use the sand eraser to get some of that away.
See, I thought it was going to have a lot more right here, mm-hmm. but there's only a small amount. And I bet
usually,
the sand eraser
if you
that.
Cut the foil close like you did, you only get that if you have like a sharp kind of corner on your foil, but it's usually not uh-huh. a problem. You can easily sand it away.
Well, in the instruction manual, they do say to avoid corners kind of being an issue that you should cut off the corners and kind of round
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
That's
You're
really
good at
pretty,
reading
though.
Instruction manuals.
I tried. That was the only thing I did was plug it in, make sure it actually turned on, and I kind of glanced through the instruction manual. But I do think like most things with crafting, you kind of have to do it once or twice to really
yep.
understand what's happening.
I feel like your die cut machine has a lot of pressure because those ends seem
it
to foil
does.
Really heavy. And then on the end of your sentiment ones, they foiled really heavy too. I wonder,
yeah.
I don't know. I think each die cut machine has its own little quirks.
Well, and this is the colored cardstock that has
so
a little
pretty.
Bit of
but,
texture to it.
But look at all the detail. I love it. And isn't that like iridescent? Make it even
it's
more
really
fun.
It's really pretty.
I love
that
it.
That is really pretty.
Yay.
Cool. All right. So just because I'm curious, I want to take some of these sentiments that I did earlier and I'm going to do them vertically. On this red cardstock, since
okay.
we're just testing things out. So,
Kim from Spellbinders, we love Kim. She's great. Kim said she recommends only rolling one way, not forward and back. Seems to work for me and also
oh.
has less overfoiling that way. That's different
oh,
than
okay.
the instruction manual, which I didn't read. But
let's try that. Let's try that. Okay, but first...
But if you think when you get a new machine like this or a gel press or something like that, you want to play with it a bit to get to know it. I do believe every you got to experiment, and that's what you're doing here. It's fun to learn all this.
Totally,
then,
for sure.
Then when you're ready to create, you can dive in and not have to call your friend in Ohio.
But my friend in Ohio is real nice.
I know. Okay. I'm happy to be here.
I'm just – oh, sorry. You can't even see me. It's off camera. But I was just – since it's going to touch it anyway, I thought I'd just go ahead and tape it to
That's
the
fine.
Foil. And then I can
yep.
go around it.
The foil is so flimsy. You just got to find which way of handling it works for
yeah.
you. There you go. So she said in the instruction manual, if you cut those sharp corners to like a rounder edge, you won't have overfoiling as much like she's doing there.
Yeah.
But the good
okay.
thing with these sentiment strips is you're going to cut them thin anyway, so that's good.
Okay, so then we got back out here so you can see what I'm doing. Okay.
And Kim says she runs hers vertical too, so maybe that'll work better for you.
Okay.
I never
okay.
have, and it's never been a problem.
All right, and I'm just going to put a little bit of a little bit of tape to hold these down so when I flip it over, it doesn't move around.
Okay.
Alrighty. Does it matter that, like, I can put it through after I've already foiled this up here, right?
Yeah, it should be fine.
Okay, so now down.
I've never
next.
Had any problem.
So,
yep.
And I'm going to get my plates. Where'd they go?
Yep.
Put those down. And then I just hit timer, right?
Yes. And somebody said they foiled their plates. I foiled my plates. I foiled my shims somehow. Look at that. It doesn't matter.
Oh,
if you
word.
Foil your plates, that means you put your foil upside down. It's okay. Your plate, your, if you
show us that plate plates, again.
It's got a pink fresh. I can't get
there you
the
go
angle right here. See how?
Oh, we can totally see it.
There you go.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Isn't that pretty? It still works fine. And if you put your foil backwards up against the hot foil plate, you will foil your plates. They'll be pretty foiled, but it'll still work fine. Ask me how I know. That's why I put the note on the side of mine.
Lovely. Okay, Seth, I've watched some videos by Yana. It's been a while. Otherwise, I probably would know more what to do, but her foiling videos are awesome. Yana's are amazing.
She works for Spellbinder, so she's got the inside scoop. She knows what works best.
Oh,
as far
already.
As smooth white cardstocks, that Glimmer Essentials from Spellbinders is great. There's also reams of Hammerhill cardstock that is very smooth, too, if you do a lot of foiling. So try one way, because that's what Kim says she does.
Yeah, I just got to be careful as I pull it out the other side.
It's not that hot.
It's toasty.
It's just a little warm. See, you don't drink coffee. You're not used to holding something hot like that.
Hey, I have hot cocoa.
I know you do. That's true.
All right, I'm just going to put this
Kathy Zilski's here.
Kathy's here.
We need to get her foiling.
Now it should be me teaching her how to foil. Okay, here we go. Let's try this. Oh, that worked out much better.
Yes, look at that. Now, is there any connection in the openings of letters? Do you know what I mean?
No, I do have a few that didn't foil completely. Hold on, let me zoom in. There are a couple little spots that didn't foil completely. Why is this not zooming in? Okay, there we go. I think my battery and my remote's going out.
That
Sorry if
good.
My camera's
yeah.
shaking. We have construction in my neighborhood, and these big trucks are like rumbling by.
Don't they know there's crafting going on?
I know.
Okay, so here's the thing. You see those spots that didn't completely foil? When I added a cardstock shim, just a piece of cardstock in between the two shims that go on top of the Glimmer machine, I found that stopped. So you may want to try that sometime.
Oh, okay.
That Making Spirits Bright looks really good.
Yeah, it's pretty close. There's just a little spot up here that's kind of like a little funky, but...
If you did this on white, smooth cardstock, it would work great. But again, this is one of those, you got to get to know your machine. I just think foiling is beautiful.
For sure. Cool. All right. Well, we've been going for almost 40 minutes. So I do one more, we'll do it on white and kind of test what we've learned. Do a cardstock shim, put the greetings in vertically. I think that'll be great. Okay, so let's see, where'd my white cardstock go? I just want to have it ready. Got some white cardstock. Should we do more those greetings again, or should we try something else?
Whatever you want. Those big mamas. Okay. That's like...
Oh, yeah. How do you do that?
You have to run it through twice.
Like, well, this one could go diagonal. Then you just have to
cut
it out.
But the falling leaves one... I did it on acetate. It was so cool. But what I did, and you might not want to do it because it takes a long time, because you have to run it through twice. But
got it.
You just put it on the tape onto a long piece of cardstock and then run it through once where half of the dye is on the gray area. And then do the whole process again, but shift it up so the other half is on the gray area.
And you just shift your paper with the dye that's taped to it.
Yep.
Got it.
Just move it all together and just do the two halves, and it worked great.
Got it.
It just takes a little time because you have to wait for it to warm up each time.
Totally. Okay. Let's just try these two little ones that are hanging out.
Somebody asked what you were using. This is Concord and Ninth white cardstock because it's very smooth, and that's what she had.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to cut some of this champagne.
See how those little strips you might have left over from other things can be used for little sentiments like this. So I always keep the little pieces totally. That are left over.
Okay.
There you go.
And then because, well.
Yeah, trim yeah. it down.
It does not need all that excessive foil.
And save that little piece. It's big enough for a sentiment.
You're right, it is.
So I'll tell you something. You want to know a secret?
Hmm?
My what? Glimmer machine has been promoted to, like, prime status in the drawer next to me because I use it so much now.
What?
I love this thing. Yeah. You know what that's like. You know, things
yeah.
are located based on how much you use them. It's right under
for
my
sure.
die cut machine.
Okay. And just because... There we go.
No, I think that's the right way. You've had the pretty foil touching the die.
Yeah, the pretty foil is touching the pretty plate.
Yep.
Okay, so now I put this down.
Yep. So the back of the plates always touch that gray area, so they get hot.
And then I put this right here.
There you go.
And then I hit
Look at you. You don't need me anymore.
It's not so hard once you get going.
Nope.
And then you just have to remember pretty foil to pretty plate. You just have to remember pretty foil to pretty plate.
All it becomes right, second nature up. And it becomes quick to do to add to your cards.
These little ones are easy to work with, you know, yep. especially because I don't have to worry about burning myself. Look at this.
Another thing you can do, if you have a big hot foil, I see that happens. If you have a big hot foil plate with a lot of solid area of foiling, I recommend using one of those super smooth white cardstocks because you'll really it's pretty flawless, and then you can color it with ink blending over it, not the foil. You color the cardstock whatever color you want, and the foil stays true.
I needed to put a cardstock shim in there, right?
Oh, you did. Okay, that's good. Sure. I just have half a piece of cardstock that's always there.
Yeah,
I think my die
I'm just using the same
it.
Cardstock that I had.
That's fine.
All right, timer says it's ready. And then Kim says, only one time through.
Okay. She's the one who's ignoring the instructions. But she's right, it looks like. On my machine, okay. The two times through is fine. All right, let's see what you got.
But you know what? It could be you do a lot of die cutting. It could be that yours has just loosened a tiny bit over time.
It could be. Yupo paper works great for this.
Really?
Because it's so smooth. It's synthetic, but it's smooth. And that, I think the Spellbinders Glimmer Essentials cardstock is actually synthetic. And it is beautiful foiled. But if you want a cheap, smooth cardstock, Hammer Hill on Amazon, I'll send you the link. That you can buy a ream of it, but most of us don't need a ream of it. So
trying to not, you know, toast my fingers.
I love how dainty you are. I like throw things around.
Oh no, look.
Oh, what happened there?
Like, I don't know. I guess maybe that extra shim was just a little
maybe.
Too much.
Do it again without the shim. It's quick.
Okay.
See, on mine, that it needs that shim. So you might have to, whoever tries this, at, you know, their own machines, you may or may not need the shim. I know a few other people need it. I remember talking to somebody from Pink Fresh. They needed it too.
Okay. Gonna get that foil. Where's a little tiny strip that I can use? I'm trying to use up all these little. Okay, this might work. Nope.
Put them closer together.
We will have to. Well, I want to die cut them apart. That's the problem.
Oh, somebody. Right, we'll just... Callie said Simon says stamp carries Hammer Hill. Is it Hammer Mill or Hammer Hill?
I think it's Hammer Mill.
I thought it was Hammer Mill, but then I thought somebody corrected me to Hammer Hill. I don't know.
Really?
I'm usually wrong about stuff, so.
I don't know. Oh, my word. Are these cooled down yet? Okay, they are cooled down. I'm like, I need to touch it. Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go.
It's Mill. Hammer Mill. Okay. Somebody told me it was Hammer
like
Hill.
Like paper mill.
Yeah.
Like paper mail.
Which made more sense to me, yes. All right, but it's ream. You don't need a ream. You just need a little bit.
Okay. Put that down. Just a little tiny bit of tape. Oh, yeah, we were going to change to EZC tape. Oops. Sorry.
That doesn't seem to be affecting it.
Okay. All right. So now
somebody said it's hammer mill time.
Hammer time. Okay, timer.
Hey, Christine, no, I got an idea.
Yeah?
While this warms up, I've got an idea.
About?
I think this should be a regular thing where you do the work and I sit here.
Okay.
Okay.
But just like wait till we turn it around and I tell you how to watercolor and
watercolor.
You're like, the difference is you want to do the foiling.
You know that the watercolor ship has sailed for me.
The good ship watercolor.
But there's got to be something else that you could teach me that doesn't make me panic. So
some fun mail art.
Ooh, that would be fun.
Ink blending and
all
that. That'd be fun. All right. Someone just said that they're smaller than a ream of the hammer mill over at Simon.
Okay, so go to Simon Says Stamp, insert hammer mill, and that will do well. But this Spellbinders Glimmer Essentials cardstock, it's white. It's great, too.
Yeah.
But it's more synthetic, so it's harder to put ink on if you want to put ink over your foiling. Or
got it.
The foil will resist the ink you put on top. Which is something I wanted to do. It's beautiful.
Okay. Put those aside.
Someone asked if you could use photo paper. I think it probably depends on the photo paper. I don't have any, so I'm not sure. I can't test it. You just want super smooth. But I use Nina too, and it's fine. There
beautiful.
We go.
There's only just a couple little spots.
That looks great.
Which it's just right here, and I know like a sand eraser would take it off.
Yeah.
Beautiful. So I think maybe just not do quite as many all at the same time. I think that helped.
I think my machine must be broken in more than yours because. My die cut machine, because I need that extra pressure. But there you go.
Awesome. Well, now I want to die cut these out. I'm just having fun sitting here talking with you. So like, hey, girl. How you doing, girl?
I'm trying to figure out when I'm going to come visit you.
Yeah.
Soon. Well, we just need COVID to go away.
Safe. Seriously?
Yep.
Yeah. This die is huge for these little greetings.
Yeah, they do that because some of the greetings are longer. So
that's true. There are
one
die
for all of them and then cut it short. Now, somebody asked about ink blending. If you want to, one of the best ways to, like if your colored cardstock is too textury and it's not taking foil, one of the things you can do is use a white smooth cardstock, do your foiling, and then use an ink blending tool and like a dye ink, like Simon Says Stamp Ink, Gina K, any of them. And just do ink blending over it, and the foil will resist that ink. Wipe it off when you're done, and you'll have color all around the foil. So you could do like a beautiful blended background, and just right over the foil. So I do the ink blending after the foiling. Yeah, somebody brought up the Yana video. As we mentioned earlier, Yana did a video where she did foil comparisons of a bunch of different cardstocks, including foil or photo paper. You can watch hers for other ideas of what works well, and maybe you have one of those options. But this Concord and Ninth Super Smooth works well, it looks like.
Yeah. Oh, that's so cute.
Isn't that great? You are officially, you've come to the dark side. You've come to the foil side, where everything's shiny.
Everything's shiny and neat. Mm-hmm. Hold on. I'm going to... I want to ink over this because I want is like a black sentiment strip with gold foil words. That was my goal for today.
Well, so you know what does foil well? Here's a little secret.
What?
a black cardstock. What? My favorite black cardstock is Hero Arts Pitch Black, but it is super thick and it's kind of smooth. It works decent, but the best is Tim Holtz Black Matte Alcohol Ink cardstock.
Oh, yeah, because it's probably synthetic.
Because it's smooth. It's really smooth.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't think it's synthetic, but it's smooth.
Okay.
What pound is the hammer mill? I think it's 100 maybe. It's pretty thick. It's not bad. Yeah. Thank you, Nikki. It's 100 pound. And it's a good 100 pound. It's not like a flimsy one. Now, I've never done black over foil. I don't know.
You haven't?
If you mess up from here on out, I don't know. Not black. No, I do it on black cardstock if I want. Foiled on black.
Well, because I'm thinking, you know, if you have a really smooth white cardstock that works and it takes ink, why not, like, just do everything on the white and then blend? Make it the color you want.
Let's see what happens. Have a dry cloth ready so you can wipe off the excess.
Not all of us have all the cardstock in the world, Jennifer.
That's because you have all the watercolors in the world, Christy.
I know. I have bought all the watercolors, and you have bought all the cardstock.
We each have our little thing. Soon between you're going to have all the foil in the world.
If there's a shortage, or if, like, we go into the end times, which some could argue now, right now is the end times. If we go into the end times and we have to use crafting supplies as money, you could use your cardstock as bartering. And I can use my watercolors for bartering. Okay. We're just going to see how this works. Okay. I don't know. We'll just see. Ooh, my
Let's
distress.
Give it a try.
My black.
Ooh, you need a re-anchor.
I do, real bad. Maybe I'll have to go get one right now. Although I do like it kind of grayish. You guys can't see it because it's not in the light, but it's really pretty. I'll hold it up here.
And then what I like to do is just take a dry cloth and really rub off all the excess ink from the foiled areas. I did one in my Pink Fresh video where I did light blue foil on white, and then I put, or no, it was bright blue foil on white, and then I ink blended with light blue. Oh, so pretty.
I got impatient.
I was waiting for that to happen.
But hey, it worked because I'm wiping it off. Does and it? It came off beautifully. Hold on, let me hold it up.
Look at
it
that.
It looks beautiful. Ah! It looks gorgeous. All right, I'm a fan. I love this. Okay,
yeah, I told
you. I have another question, and this might be like asking too much of this glimmer machine. Uh-oh. Can you do like regular foiling, like the Simon Sentiment strips? You can put foil on it because it doesn't have enough pressure, right? Is that
I
why?
Don't think so. I've never tried. Just use a laminator for that.
Okay, got it.
You have a laminator.
I mean, I have
right?
a mink machine, but I was just hoping
mink,
that I
mink works
didn't
well
have
too.
To have. More counter right, space I know. For more tools.
I'm not sure. I've never tried it, but I believe every crafter should have a laminator because it's great for like making dividers for your stamps, organizing things. So I just use my $20 laminator for those.
Got it.
Can I tell you another thing about these plates? Because then you'll be more addicted. Okay,
yes,
so
you
like
tell
your...
Me. Tell me more.
Hold that leaf one up.
Hold on. What leaf one? Oh, the big one?
Yeah.
The big one.
Now,
yeah.
Now, something else you can do with this that's fun that does not require foil or the machine. You know how you can make an impression with a die using the embossing mat in your Spellbinders? You know that flexible tan mat? Let me get mine.
Totally. I know which one you talk about.
Let me get it out. So you've got this. Now, if you want to make an impression with a die, you put your cardstock on it. Then a die, and you run it through, and it presses the die in. You can do that with your hot foil.
Ooh, like plate. An embossing folder.
Yes, and what's cooler is you lightly run ink over the raised area. This will be for another video, but you can lightly run ink over the raised area of your foil plate, put it down carefully, and it looks like faux letterpress.
Ooh.
I know. See?
Well, thank you, Jennifer, for joining me today. I feel much better. It's not as intimidating as I had feared.
You just got to play with it a little bit.
My goal for today has been achieved. I just wanted to make a black sentiment strip with these. I think I have like three of these Spellbinders sets that have all, well, no, I think I have like four or five sets that, I mean, I bought like a year ago, and one of these is more recent, but I was just like, this is what I want. I really just want some like sentiment strips, you know, to like add a little shine.
I would keep trying and try vertical with no added shim and all that, several of them, because I'm able to do a bunch of them at once and they all come out good. So keep trying with it, because I think you'll be able to get good results. So you can do foil a bunch of sentiments and have a bunch ready. I have a little spot in my drawer where I have leftover ones just ready to go. Look at that.
Awesome.
Isn't it glorious?
I love it.
And if you've ever done gold embossing powder, this is significantly shinier and it's smooth.
Yeah.
Very smooth.
For sure.
It presses it into the paper. Isn't that cool?
How fun. I really think I'm just going to go ahead and make some little sentiment strips this afternoon that I can just have on hand, you know, as I make holiday cards for my holiday card series.
Yep.
Because y'all know I love a black sentiment strip.
Yeah. Was that the silver on there or gold? I can't remember.
This is the champagne.
The champagne. Color. Okay.
Yeah.
Keep in mind there's like opal ones. There's black glossy foil too. It's really cool.
There is.
On like a
nice
red cardstock. Yeah.
Sweet. Yeah. Foils. I've got a few other plates here that I was considering playing with today. I'll just show you them. I've got the mini slimline falling dots from Simon, which I think I may have shown earlier. There's the slimline congratulations. And then I have this fun dot one, basic dots from Yana.
Yep.
And then there's this other one that's not Christmas sentiments. It's all kind of like everyday sentiments, hence its name, mini everyday sentiments. And then the holiday ones that you guys saw earlier, those are the ones that I've kind of amassed over the last year because I was like, I really want to do this, but I just hadn't done it. Hadn't had that.
And the neat thing is more and more companies are doing them. So I think it's neat. I mean, foiling isn't for everyone, but it's nice to have that option for those that do like it.
Totally.
And especially when line up with dies and stamps, I think it's fun. You know, that way everybody can find something they like.
So Jennifer, are we going to have class, online card classes?
So this is really what your motive was, to get me live where I can't say no.
Well, no, because we want to do something. We just don't know entirely what we're doing yet, right?
I think we should do, there's three classes I think we need to do.
Okay.
See, now I'm going to put you on the spot.
Okay.
One of them is holiday. One's holiday. One is gel press.
Okay.
Which we both don't know a whole lot about, but that would be fun.
Yeah, we would be learning as we go along, for sure. And then
I do
teaching
the
our
stampers
tricks that we learn.
Can you guess what the third one is?
I don't know. You're trying to show off your apron? I don't know.
No. I'm dancing because foiling.
Oh, foiling. Yes, yes. We could do foiling.
Wouldn't that be fun?
Although people have got a crash course right here.
Oh, well. Clearly, you can see we have stuff to learn.
It's true. And you kind of have to get into a little bit of a different headspace because you have to kind of think like, okay, how can I layer these foil things together? How can I piece them together? You have to think about it a little bit differently. So,
and that's why I suggest playing with it like you've done here before just jumping right into a card idea, because you need to get to know your machine, what works best, find a paper you're happy with. But really, colored cardstocks will be great with this too.
Awesome. Okay, so question. Mm-hmm. Now, you said that your Glimmer hot foil system has found its home in your craft room where it's nearby so you can use it all the time. Is that the one that you prefer over the Gemini hot foil press machine just because for ease of use, or do you have a preference?
I don't have a preference. The reason I've been using the Glimmer machine is my Gemini is plugged in. It's in a drawer next to me and it's plugged in and I can't really bring it up on my table for a video. The Spellbinders is much easier to bring up. So it's better for filming. So that's why I started using it. And also the Spellbinders folks are really awesome and I talk to them a lot. So, but I don't think from my experience and from what I've learned, all the foil machines work great. So if you have a different die cut machine, you can get a different foil machine to go with it and do things in the same way.
Gotcha.
And Spellbinders just
has.
Yeah.
Oh, I was going to mention that When I asked you if it worked with other machines, if this Glimmer, Spellbinders Glimmer machine worked with other die cutting machines, I just remembered when I was shopping on their website, and I was making the list of links that are down below. If you guys want to check out some of the stuff I've mentioned or shown today, that's linked down below. When I was making that list of products, I noticed that they mention on their website that it is compatible with all these other machines. And there's like a list of like 15 okay. machines or something. So if you need additional information on if the Glimmer Good. Hot foil system works with your machine you already have, go to the Spellbinders website and check that description, because yeah. they probably will have your machine listed.
A long time ago, I looked and that wasn't there. I think they might have added that, which I think is a good thing. But keep in For mind, sure. no matter what brand the plates are, they all work with the different foil machines from my experience.
Cool.
But so, make sure yeah, you get the right foil. Like,
seems like the Simon plates are like they have a higher profile than the Glimmer ones.
I don't know.
I'm going to have to test it out and find out.
But they worked. I used all of those plates there except the congratulations one, and they worked wonderfully.
No Man, problem. Cool.
They're just so beautiful. You're going to be addicted well, too, my darling.
Well, what I might have to have you come back to teach me some die cut inlay.
somebody said that their Glimmer machine works with the Big Shot Plus with no problem.
Oh, good.
And oh, die good. Cut inlay, I'm happy to do that too. Anything I can do to help you, because you're always helping me in life. So it's about time I do something useful.
Tell you what cameras to buy. Tell you what mm-hmm. cameras to buy. Hey, if any of you are wondering, Jennifer, if she recommends a recipe, oh, yeah. it's a winner.
But yeah. I can't really take credit for that because my husband does the cooking.
Did he find the chicken noodle soup recipe?
No, I find the recipe and I give them to him.
Oh, and then you're like, hey, do this. Test it out.
Did you See, try I it? Think
not yet, but I have some chicken that I made in the instant pot yesterday that I've shredded, and I'm like, it's so good. I want kind of want to put it in something.
Well, this recipe starts with the chicken, and you make your own broth.
Oh,
so
oh,
I sweet. Don't. You can probably okay. change it.
I like that. The one recipe from you that I love that I've gone back to year after year is the basically keto pumpkin cheesecake bars.
Oh yeah.
Oh my gosh. If any of you guys need like an amazing, like no sugar, like holiday treat for Thanksgiving or Christmas or year round, this is so good. I'll try to remember to link it down below in the video description. I wish I knew exactly whose recipe it is off the top of my head, but I don't.
Well, I it remember is a winner. I was, the reason I tried it is I was trying to cut back carbs to see if it helped with migraines. It didn't. So it was a failed thing, but it was Thanksgiving and I wanted to have a treat. So I made that, and it makes a big thing, right?
Yeah,
and
a whole pan.
I was mm-hmm. eating it like crazy. And I remember my mother-in-law saying to me, you know, if you eat that much, it becomes high in carbs.
It's probably true.
I'm like, oh dear. Okay.
Well, my latest thing, I was telling Dana about this yesterday, our friend Dana Joy, because she called me, and I was telling her that my new obsession, it's already an obsession, and I'm still waiting for the Amazon packages that will have everything I need to make it. Uh-oh. But apparently there are all these people on YouTube that make this keto yeast bread in a bread machine. Mm. I miss bread so much. So I mean, you have to buy kind of odd ingredients like vital wheat gluten and flaxseed meal and things like that. So I as the sucker that I am, I ordered everything. I will report back.
I didn't know you were doing keto, so I didn't know that.
Well, I'm not. I'm not doing keto, but I'm diabetic. So yeah. I love this whole like keto trend the last few years because the keto recipes are go-to for diabetics. And I don't sure. do keto. I do more of just a moderate carb. Yeah. But
that's what I thought.
I've just discovered like I can eat a potato. I'm good. Like my blood sugars can handle that. But if I have bread, bread hates me. But I love
and bread.
Bread
is so good.
I know.
Another thing, this isn't good for your low carb, but did you ever make my Bailey's chocolate? Or no, was it Bailey's? Espresso?
Is it brownies or something?
No. Yeah, what no, they're chocolate chunk cookies, and it's got, I think, Bailey's in it, and espresso.
And then didn't Jeff Lindbergh make them, and he was like, this is life-changing?
you will never know happiness until you've tried them. And now people want these recipes. I will take photos of these recipes and put them on Instagram stories so you can find
them. Thank you. Thank
these
you. Cookies, or if anyone has them and can just put them in the chat, that'd be great.
Mike doesn't know anything about cooking. Otherwise, he'd put them in there.
Well, he could go grab the chicken noodle soup recipe that's on your Facebook page. You could go grab that.
Are you even on Facebook? Oh, yeah, you are.
You know what? Hold on. Hold on 1 minute. Let me see, because I know I have the cheesecake bars in a text message.
Those espresso cookies.
I make right up. Keto pumpkin cheesecake bars from savorytooth.com.
That's a website that has good recipes. Savorytooth.com. Okay.
Let me see if I can paste this in. Okay. There's that one recipe. What was the other recipe we were talking about?
The Bailey's espresso cookies. I put it on my Facebook page a long time ago. I'll have to. Can we come back and add it into your YouTube description?
Bailey's espresso chocolate chip cookies from Bakery by Nature or Baker by Nature?
Maybe.
That's got to be it. It's got like 5 stars.
Oh. And they're big. You can make them like.
Yeah.
You
totally
you
big.
Can use an ice cream scoop with the
is
dough.
This like, does that picture look familiar?
Maybe. I print it, so I keep it in a recipe book. But I will get, I'll find the recipe and you can add it in the description.
I'm pasting this in the chat. We'll see if that's the right one. So what we need to do is just have Jennifer and Christina's link hour. And we just like all the recommendations.
Nobody's better at sharing things we find than the two of us.
Yeah.
We could make everybody's life happier with the things that we find.
Have you tried that bone-in chicken thigh instant pot recipe yet? Oh, it's a good one. We had it the other night.
Mm-mm.
And then I had extra chicken thighs, and that's what I cooked, and now I have the shredded chicken in the fridge.
You know what we did have the other night was bacon-wrapped pork tenderloin in the Instant Pot.
Ooh. We have a pork tenderloin we need to use. You need to send me that recipe.
Okay. It's on, I think it's Skinny Taste. Most of our recipes are Skinny Taste.
Oh, yeah. My mom still makes that, what is it, Santa Fe chicken? Crock-pot
Santa Fe chicken. One
mm-hmm.
of my all-time favorites. Mm.
Yes. I don't know how we got from foiling to food. I think I brought up your
recipe. I always take it to food. You know this.
Oh, I think I took it there. All right. I love you, Jennifer. Thank you so much for helping today.
Love you, too. I can't wait to hug you.
Yes. And thank you all for joining us for this random Christina and Jennifer hour.
We promise next time we'll be more organized or maybe not.
We were pretty organized now.
I'm just sitting here.
Well, you didn't have to do anything. You were just like talking and giving and throwing down some knowledge. So
I'm like saying, hey, guys, am I doing this right in the comments?
Well, you're just doing it from memory from when you do it. Yeah. And I think that's almost better than someone who has looked at the instructions and they haven't ever revered from it. Because if you don't ever revere from the instructions, you don't know if it could be improved.
Yeah, so and I think once you play with your machines, you get to know it better. And
yes.
Man, it's fun.
What did they say in design school? You need to know the rules so you can break them appropriately.
Yeah, I do that a lot with my die cutting.
See, that's the fun part.
Yep.
Love it. All right.
Until you break something, right?
Thank you all for watching. I will not have an edited version of this because there was just too much good content. So you all are just going to have to watch it. There will not be an edited version. Sorry, guys.
There'll be nothing left.
I know. It's like foil and then done. I'm going to try foiling. The end. So anyway, thanks for joining me and Jennifer today. I will see you guys hopefully soon. Well, actually tomorrow morning for a new card video. Thanks for joining. We'll see you guys later.
Thank you.